New this morning, secrets of our German ancestors finally being revealed, all thanks to students at a Susquehanna Valley college.
This isn't just any German class. Professor Rick Chamberlain is putting his advanced language students to the test, all because of a request from an archivist at the Lebanon County Historical Society.
He had this archive full of German materials that he didn't know how to read, and so he was wondering if I could help him. And the idea came to, let's have a class get on it.
Should be easy, right? Especially for students like Lauren Dubransky, who minors in German.
It's a bit like reading Shakespeare for the first time.
Okay, maybe Tyrone Fosnut, who was born and raised in Germany.
It's almost like learning a new language.
It's a matter of learning a new alphabet in order to be able to read these.
Here's the problem. The handwriting from documents and letters, some from the 1700s, are in a style that Germans no longer use.
Only 1 in 100 Germans can actually read this, so that us, like 10 students, can even read this and understand it. It's pretty significant.
I didn't know exactly what all documents we would be encountering, but it's been really, really interesting.
Some of the stuff on people coming over here who killed children to get more food, it's documented, it's in like history books that, okay, somebody actually did that.
To see how they treated things or what they used, it's just like unthinkable today.
It's such an interesting aspect of the local history here that would otherwise go lost if nobody knew German and could read these documents. This is one way to preserve part of Pennsylvania's heritage.
And those students will be presenting their findings to the Lebanon County Historical Society this Sunday, 1:30. It is open to the public so you can hear what all they have found out through these documents. In the meantime, Professor Chamberlain says he hopes to make this a permanent course. They have a lot more to translate. So
that's incredible. First of all, it's great to see that history is preserved in that
way.
Second of all, it's hard enough to learn the current version
of
a foreign
language versus
let alone
something that's not used anymore.
Great for them. Good for them.
Yep.